A bunch of right-wing commentators have gone full fundamentalist, and they're claiming that the left are using witches and demons against Donald Trump.
Can the spirits hurt us if we are both Christians?
The Bible says a curse causeless cannot lie. And some, that may can't rest on you, demon power, they try to curse you, but in the name of Jesus, you take it back. And I might add, I read that a bunch of witches has gotten together to put a curse on Trump, and I think the Christians need to be praying for him to defend him, but at the same time, send those curses back where they came from.
This is an evil day, and, you know, Steve Bannon is right. This conflict is going to heat up because the other side, they're throwing everything they have into the breach, including now demons. I mean, realize what the left is doing now in this battle over the future of our country. They are throwing the very demons of hell at those that are trying to represent what is good and best and right for this country.
So all you fakes want to get close to God, stop being cowards. Be like Donald Trump. And that witch raises her head on the day that she publicly supports witchcraft and Satanism and black magic. They were in the news saying, hope Trump dies, voodoo dolls. Have you seen what happened to Haiti? What happened in New Orleans? Voodoo and devil worship. Isn't it funny they have devil worship in Africa, even before they ever heard from Christians? And China had devil worship, and the Aztecs had devil worship. Because it's real, folks. It's an archetype, either way you cut it. It's a spirit. And any time a culture starts invoking Satan, every time it happens, there are mass wars, casualties, and death. And only corrupt, twisted, weak societies ever call on Satan. Any strong society always calls on the Great Spirit, as some Native Americans called it. And we're talking about the same thing, in my view.
So God gave us a reprieve, and this thing is spiritual. It really is spiritual. And so we need, this land is so important, and I counsel you, pray for this nation, pray for the president, pray for this nation. But what's being done against him, surpasses, it's not human, it's a spiritual thing.
Where do I begin with this? You know what I think gets under my skin more than anything? How the way they talk about it and the way they frame it, they act like they're straight shooters and that they're saying something factual. You know, like, it's not even, when you say something so ridiculous, you would think any normal human being, even if they believe what they're saying here, that they would frame it as like, this is what I think is happening. Like, I think there are demons and witches and there's spiritual warfare going on against our beloved dear leader, President Trump. And they'd frame it as like, maybe. But no, these guys are so fucking far gone and so ridiculous that they frame it as if they're discussing facts. Like, they know for sure. Like, Alex Jones is Mr., I figured everything out. I'm the genius who read between the lines and figured out all the conspiracies that are happening everywhere. And I'm here to give you the truth. That's why it's called Infowars.com. It's information, people. Info. And then he goes on to say, yeah, look at what happened in Haiti. And Haiti and New Orleans, I mean, there's voodoo and devil worship. Quote, it's real, folks. Right, so the earthquake in Haiti, Hurricane Katrina in New Orleans, that's all because they did voodoo and devil worship, and that's God going, mwahaha, I will punish you by sending weather events that will affect you in a negative way. Mwahaha. How do you believe that, man? Like, even the premise of what you're talking, right from the premise, you're wrong. See, in order to make that claim, there would need to be proof that there indeed are, you know, demons and angels and a God who's controlling the fucking weather. You skip right past all that shit, because of course you can't prove it, because you're just a metaphysical nonsense believing clown, and you go right to, not only do all those things exist, but I know they're going after my political enemies, and I know they're going after the people who do voodoo and devil worship. Like, in these guys' minds, I'm not kidding, I think that they really believe, like, okay, witches are real in, like, the fly around on a broomstick have green skin sense. Like, I know sometimes on the show I've said before, witches aren't real, and people who are Wiccans are like, how dare you? I'm offended. Pipe down. You know what I mean. You could practice whatever goofy religion you want to practice and call yourself whatever you want to call yourself. I'm talking about the ones you see in, like, the Halloween fucking movies with the broomsticks and the, my little pretty, with the fucking noses and the warts and the green face and shit. Like, I think they really believe in it. Look, so who was it? Robertson first said, witches put a curse on Trump. What? Fisher says they're throwing demons of hell at Trump, as if what? Like Michael Moore and Code Pink get in a room and they're like, have we unleashed the demons of hell on Trump yet? Jones with the voodoo and the devil worship, quote, it's real, folks. Mr. Straight Shooter just totally going full religious fundamentalist on us. And Robertson at the end was spiritual warfare. There's spiritual warfare going on against Trump. You know, this is what you do when you can't have a discussion about the actual policies that he's pushing for. They can't actually defend what he's doing. So this is what you do. You say everybody who's against him are corrupted by demons and Satan and they're witches and, you know, they're attacking him because they're profoundly evil. Well, why are you guys saying you? There's no evidence of that. You don't even know if there is fucking metaphysical wizards in space with the, and there's, again, I certainly don't believe it, but apparently they believe it. So why would you do it? Because they can't fight against the fact that, well, Trump, in his very first move as president, his first executive order, increased taxes on the middle class. That's what he did. There was an effective tax break for first-time homebuyers. He rolled that back. That was his very first act as president. They can't say, hey, that's wrong, so what do you say? Devil worshippers, voodoo believers, you're using black magic against our dear leader. You know, they can't defend the fact that he just appointed, a Goldman Sachs guy to Treasury Secretary, a guy who owned One West Bank and was foreclosing on senior citizens all across the country. This guy cares about the people? This is the right guy for Treasury Secretary? A guy who was at a criminal organization like Goldman Sachs, who did fraud as a business model? Guys responsible for crashing the fucking economy. Gary Cohn, who was the president of Goldman Sachs, and now he leads Trump's economic council. You can't defend that now, can you? You can't defend Trump passing an executive order that says, I now am decreeing that coal companies are allowed to pollute our waterways. Can't defend that now, can you? You can't defend Mr. Alex Jones, Mr. Anti-imperialism, because that was one of his biggest things he used to talk about under Bush all the time and under Obama. All military adventurism, we gotta stop this, not necessary, this is the Illuminati and the Bilderbergs doing their thing. Now, all of a sudden, Trump just proposed a $54 billion increase in U.S. military spending, when our military budget, already over 50% of our discretionary budget, goes to the military. We spend more than the next 9 biggest countries combined, and most of them are our allies, on military spending. We already have the biggest military in human history. Trump increases it by $54 billion. And where's Alex Jones now? Now all of a sudden he's got nothing to say. Now all of a sudden U.S. imperialism is a good thing because Daddy Trump is doing it. This is what you do. When you can't fight on the policy issues, you just strawman your opponents. And the way that he's strawmanning his opponents here is the most ridiculous of all possible ways. Because you go to the shit that's religious. You go to the shit that's fundamentalist. You go to the shit that's metaphysical. You go to the shit that's made up. Their heads are planted firmly in their ass, and all they're doing is playing defense now. That's what it is. And the best defense is a good offense, so you just accuse the people who are against your dear leader of being demons and being witches and, you know, casting curses on them. Or maybe he's just a really shitty president, and the only good thing he's done so far is kill TPP. Maybe that, or how about that? That's the reality. You can't acknowledge that reality, so you argue that wizards in space are engaged in a cosmic battle, and all of your political enemies just happen to be on the side of Satan and demons. Cool story, bro.